dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of Sunday, July 8th, puts us on our guard against one of the most serious risks that we can take as Christians. Like Jesus' fellow citizens, we can deceive ourselves by thinking or knowing Him, while in reality, what we know is the image we have made of Him. We believe that we know Him, and yet we are scandalized when Jesus reveals Himself and reveals to us the incredible and extraordinary God's desire for us. In fact, dear brothers and sisters, is it not true that many Christians today in the church, when they hear the teaching of Jesus, infallibly offered by the magisterium of the Holy Father Francis, are scandalized? Just in the same way His compatriots were scandalized. When, for example, Jesus invites to love enemies, when He reminds to everybody that those who help the sick, the hungry, the prisoner, the refugee, are actually helping Him. When Jesus makes you understand that the only true family is the one based on marriage between a man and a woman, open to life. When Jesus manifests to Christian spouses His desire that they love each other just as He has loved this church, that is, with a tender, fruitful, and indissoluble love until to the end. When He reminds to everybody that human life must be defended from conception until natural death. When He invites everybody to be custodians and not destroyers of our unique, unrepeatable, beautiful common house, the earth. When Jesus invites everybody to follow each road, to go pilgrim through all the streets, to tear down all the walls and overcome each frontier, to go to the existential and geographical peripheries of the world, manifesting the justice and peace of God. Dear brothers and sisters, we do not want to see in the face of Jesus the wonder for our unbelief. But by doing ours, the prayer of the apostles, we will never get tired of asking Him, Lord, increase our faith. Dear brothers and sisters, it's all for now. Ciao, and God bless you always.